across America ready to put on their tool belt and get dirty. I don't know about you. I don't want the newest airports, the fastest railroads to be built in China. I want them to be built right here in the United States of America. I don't want any of our kids to study in subpar schools. I want all our kids to study in great schools. So there's work to be done. There are workers ready to do it. Let's pass this jobs bill right away. Passing this jobs bill will put thousands of teachers in Virginia and across America back to work when we need them most. This is a new age. Everybody here knows that. If you want a good job, a good career, if we want America to succeed, then we've got to have the best trained, most highly skilled workers in the world. You've got places like South Korea that are adding teachers to prepare their kids for a global economy. We're laying off our teachers in droves. It's unfair to our kids. It undermines their future. It undermines our future. It has to stop. Let's pass this bill and put our teachers back in the classroom where they belong. Passing this bill gives companies new tax credits to hire America's veterans. A lot of veterans here in Richmond and all across Virginia. We ask these men and women to leave their careers or interrupt their careers, leave their families, risk their lives to fight for us. They come home and they can't find a job? The last thing they should have to do is fight for a job when they come home. Pass this bill now and put these folks to work. Pass this jobs bill and we'll give small business owners here in Richmond and here in Virginia a tax cut for hiring new workers, but also for raising workers' wages. Cut their payroll taxes in half. That will give small businesses money they can use to hire more workers. Pass this bill and we give hundreds of thousands of disadvantaged youth the hope and the dignity of a summer job next year. And that instills in them good habits that'll last a lifetime. It'll make it easier for them to find a job in the future and to continue their education. Passing this bill will give companies a tax credit for hiring anybody who spent more than 6 months looking for work. And there are a lot of folks like that. This has been a terrible recession. And you know, I get letters from folks, and they write to me about what it's like month after month, writing letters, sending out resumes, knocking on doors. And folks get discouraged. And when they get discouraged, at some point they drop out of the labor force. And it's very hard for them then to get reattached. And you've got some employers now, if you've been out of work for a long time, even if they're looking for a job, or even if they're looking to hire, a lot of times they'll say, well, you've been out of work too long, I'm not sure we want to hire you. Which is not fair. It's not right. So this bill will help people on unemployment insurance to do temporary work to build skills while looking for a full-time job. And we should extend unemployment insurance for another year. Not only is the right thing to do, not only is the right thing to do for those families, but if we cut off unemployment insurance right now, that's money that millions of unemployed folks can't spend on their basic needs. So that money comes out of the economy. That means businesses have fewer customers, and the economy for everybody, including those who have work, will shrink. That'd be a big, unnecessary blow to this economy. Passing this bill will give a typical working family a $1,500 tax cut next year. So This boosts the $1,000 tax cut the Democrats and Republicans already have passed for this year. We can't allow that tax cut to expire. It would hit middle-class families with a tax increase at the worst possible time. And some of you may have heard, I said to folks yesterday, especially my good Republican friends, I said, you guys have made pledges never to raise taxes on everybody, ever again. You can't make an exception when the tax breaks go into middle-class people. So this is the American Jobs Act. It will lead to new jobs for construction workers, teachers, veterans, young people, the long-term unemployed. Provide tax credits for businesses and workers. And it will not add to the deficit. It will be paid for. Look, we spent a whole summer fussing about the deficit. And it is legitimate for us to get a government that is living within its means, just like families do. Now, Democrats and Republicans have already agreed to cut spending by about $1 trillion over the next decade. They've agreed to identify another $1.5 trillion savings by the end of the year.